So this video looks at the Kaaba in more detail. And we see this black line on the floor, and what this indicates is the start of our walk, known as the tawaf, around the Kaaba. We start the walk at the black stone, which we kiss or touch or just point towards depending on how busy it is. And then we come around and see the door of the Kaaba, which is the gold thing behind the curtain, and underneath you can see the brickwork of the Kaaba. So as we come around, we see this gold rectangular object which is at the roof of the Kaaba. This is actually a water spout which prevents the roof from building up water in the case of rain. This semicircular region that we see here, that is known as a Hijr Ismail, and what it indicates is the original foundation area of the Kaaba. So when you walk around the Kaaba, it's important that you walk on the outside of that semicircular region. And this corner that we're coming up to, this is known as a Yemeni corner, which you touch as you go around the Kaaba. So we come to the black stone again, and that completes one walk around the Kaaba. You do this 7 times, and this is the tawaf. You can find out more details about this, and you can subscribe for more videos at the website.
Thank you. Thank you. a rapid dive out of harm's way. But time is on the eagle's side. The snake must surface for air. The special attraction of Snake Island for the sea eagle is quite clear. It is a beautiful abduction, a seemingly effortless kill. Masterful hunter is not invincible. The eagle has no special protection against snake bite. A thrashing snake locked in a death grip could make a kill of its own. A closer look reveals that the snake did get a piece of the eagle's leg, but was probably unable to inject its venom. The eagle falters, but ultimately prevails.